My name is Stonebwoy. Stone as in my maiden name, to be called Stone, insurance man, my real name. But my first name is Livingstone. Yeah, I don't pronounce it Livingstone. My most important thing, I believe that on the subject, using the creative industry to impact change in society, there's a lot we can do and a lot we have to do, you know. And personally, I believe that I have stood for and I still stand for the fact that I will use this platform as an artist, you know, to do a lot of things I've done already. First and foremost, creating music for people to dance to or live with and vibe to, I think is a form of change. As in, you know, people get inspired. You know what I mean? People get encouraged. In all sorts of situations, people find a way to use our music as a creative material to find, you know, some sort of relief, happiness, whatever that they can derive from the music.
Yeah. I'd want to find out what exactly you mean by the ghetto youth. And does it mean your music is not channeled to influence the people from privileged backgrounds as well?
Sometimes it depends on the song and what I'm trying to, or what message I'm sending across. So it doesn't only mean that I'm defending or I'm representing the less privileged, but I mean that anybody who could find themselves in that sort of situation.
Is it just that you are making the music for us to listen to and change our ways, or aside the music, there's some effort you are making? No, some actions we are taking to make sure that
whatever you say.
I from somewhere, you know what I mean? I wouldn't necessarily speak about it if I'm not drawn to the cause, you know? Yeah, so basically, I've had it in mind for a very long time to even have a foundation, and I think this year has materialized, and the Livingstone Foundation is here. We're going to be launching it soon, you know, so that we can do well to, you know, create more awareness and even solve some of the problems that we can.
The question is kind of related to our problem. I get more problems. So I just want to know, what keeps you from getting lost in the whole Hollywood being Stonebwoy? Because, I mean,
thank you very much.
I always find it important to connect back to my beginnings. Because that's the only way you can have an opportunity to look back and then realize, like when you get too much, when you get caught up too much in the vibes, in the parties, in the limelight, there are certain things that I do, like part of the foundation's job, visit colleagues, visit people who have, you know, who are hurt. So that you know, I mean, people who are sick and all those ones. Not only them. But I find time to also read and want to know about what actually happening to humanity that makes us human. Because I know that majority of us, even non-stars, you know, tend to stay on the social media type of life. And trust me, it actually helps us to forget a lot of things that we're actually living on Earth. You know, you can be in your phone, not on your phone, you can be inside of your phone and live there for years. That happens a lot, and at the position that I find myself, I'm forced to live inside of my phone and inside of the hype, but I'm not, because I think I still have a house in Ashesi, so I see the reality and I know I'm one. So these are the little things I do. It's not too much, you know what I mean? But don't take me for granted, though.
Why are you making this journey? If I understand correctly, this is part of a tour that you're going to do. Other universities as well, or if you're just coming here, what is your message to university students, should they be more creative? Should they drop out of school? Should they start singing? What is your message to young people that have gathered here today?
Thank you very much.
Some do not have to start to sing.
Come.
You know?
Okay.
And then they can always blend it together. You know, it's all about finding yourself. I promise that people we started with are not here today. And they don't understand why. It should be divine at least. It should be divine. You should find yourself. You know? Just like here, other people would read other courses and finish up not to do that for a living. It all lies down to finding yourself, and that can take some time. So let them not drop out. I know persons who are medical practitioners now, and now they'll be like, my brain, I'm going to do business. They're going to start now, all those ones. So it will take time to find ourselves. And I believe that it's our system. Excuse me, this is Ghana. Something I trust is that in most of the developed nations, by the age of 16, you may have gone through certain other drills that will draw you to what you definitely want to do. And you will be allowed to, because here, as we find ourselves, sometimes you want to sing. Your mother doesn't want you to sing. A typical example of that one is that Dr. Ilate. His father has to, excuse me, rest in peace, for him to start his musical career at the age of 40. So even becoming a doctor couldn't satisfy the person himself, you know. I hope I said something right. So please don't drop out of school. Education, you can always, you know, we all learn either by formally or informal. We all have to keep learning as we go.